Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. In this video, we will discuss Class 10 Mathematics, Chapter 2 Polynomials, Exercise 2.3, Question Number 1 Solution. Divide the polynomial p of x by the polynomial g of x and find the quotient and remainder in each of the following. So here there are three subproblems. Let us solve the subproblems one by one. To solve this subproblem, we have to apply the polynomial division algorithm. About that, we have discussed in the last video. So first, you please refer that video before solving these problems. So here, let us solve the first subproblem. They have given two polynomials, p of x and g of x. Now we have to divide the p of x polynomial by the g of x polynomial. That means from this we can say that here the divisor is nothing but g of x. So we have the divisor as divisor is equal to g of x, that is equal to x square minus 2. Then dividend is equal to p of x, that is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. So first we need to find out the divisor and dividend. After that, we need to arrange the divisor and dividend polynomial in the decreasing order of their degrees. That means highest degree term has to come first. So here already they have given the arranged values. See, for divisor we have first degree as 2. Here it is 0. So it is already in decreasing order. Here we have 3. Then here we have 2. And for this we have the degree 1. And for this 0. So these two values are already in decreasing order. So no need to make any arrangement. Now let us start the division process. So we have to divide now x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3 with x square minus 2. So when we perform the division process, the first step is we have to divide the highest term of the dividend by the highest degree term. Here the highest degree term is x cube, that we have to divide by the highest degree term of the divisor. See, in this case you can see that here in the case of dividend, the highest degree term is x cube, then that you have to divide by the highest degree term of the divisor. In the case of divisor, highest degree term is x square, so x cube divided by x square, this will give you the answer as x. So now here we got the first term of the quotient, that is nothing but the answer x. After getting the first term of the quotient, this value you have to multiply with the divisor. That means x quotient first term is x, x into the divisor. Divisor is x square minus 2. So this gives the answer x into x square, that is x cube, x into minus 2, that is minus 2x. So here we got x cube minus 2x. This value you need to write under this. So here we have 4 terms, here we have got only 2 terms. Whenever you are writing this term under this, you have to write the value under the respective degree term. That means here we have x cube. So let us write that x cube under this. Then we have minus 2x. We don't have here x square coefficient or x square value. We directly have minus 2x. So that we will write here minus 2x under this x coefficient value, under this x degree term. Next, we need to perform the subtraction. So when we perform the subtraction, here we have actually plus sign. So this becomes minus. And here, see, we have already minus sign. So this value, this sign become plus. Minus minus becomes plus. So here we have plus and here we have minus. So x cube minus x cube, that will get cancelled. Then here we have minus 3x square, and here we don't have any term, so that we can write as it is minus 3x square. Then 5x minus minus become plus, so 5x plus 2x, that gives the answer 7x. Then here we don't have any term, so minus 3. So now here, see, you got the new dividend value. Now for the next step, we have to consider this as our new dividend. That means this value you have to divide by this. Again, you have to repeat the same process. For this new dividend, take the highest degree term from the new dividend and divide that by the highest degree term of the divisor. So here in the new dividend, the highest degree term is minus 3x square. Then divide that term by the highest degree term of the divisor. Divisor is same, highest degree term of the divisor is x square. So minus 3x square divided by x square. So here x square and x square get cancelled, so we get the answer as minus 3. This minus 3 becomes the second term of the quotient. That means that we can write here minus 3. Now we got the second term of the quotient. That term you multiply with the divisor. That is minus 3 into x square minus 2. Minus 3 into x square minus 2. That gives the answer minus 3 into x square minus 3x square. Then minus 3 into minus 2, that is plus 6. Now you write this value under this particular value, so that we have here, see, minus 3x square. So minus 3x square. Then we don't have any value related to x. Plus 6 we have, so that plus 6 you have to write under this constant term. You have to write under constant term. Next, you need to perform the subtraction. So here when we perform the subtraction, already we have your minus sign. So this value minus minus become plus. Here we don't have any term. Here we have a minus plus sign. That means this is minus. So minus 3x square plus 3x square. So minus 3x square and plus 3x square, that will get cancelled. Then here we have 7x. Here we don't have any term. So 7x. Then minus 3 minus 6, that becomes minus 9. So now here you got the new dividend value. Again, here you have to see whether we can continue the division process or not. Whenever we perform the division, we have to do the division process till the divisor degree is greater than or equal to this. Suppose if the new dividend degree is less than the divisor degree, or if new dividend is equal to 0, then we have to stop the process. See, now in this case, here we have continued the process, because here we have the degree as x square. Here we have x square. So degree values are equal. Here we have done the process because here we have the degree as x cube. So degree is greater than the divisor degree. Whereas now in this case, we have x to the power 1, this is, and here we have the degree x square. That means this new dividend degree is less than this divisor degree. So that means we have to stop the process. So when we stop the process, now here we got the quotient value as well as remainder. So here we can say that the quotient is equal to x minus 3. So quotient is equal to x minus 3, and the remainder value is nothing but the last value, whatever we have got, that is 7x minus 9. So for this, answer is quotient is x minus 3 and remainder is 7x minus 9. Thanks for watching.